Newly minted Nobel laureate William Kaelin greeted with cheers at his Dana-Farber Cancer Institute lab.
She's flooded with a sense of appreciation and what a privileged life I've had scientifically.
Just a few hours before the rush of reporters and even requests from strangers for his picture,
two people stopped me for selfies on the teeth.
Kaelin was going to bed knowing the Nobel Prize announcement was hours away. At that time, he thought at best there was a 2% chance he would be one of the winners. He even dreamed the time came and went with no phone call, only to realize it was still the middle of the night.
And I looked at the clock and I said, oh my God, it's 2:30 in the morning. I think I have to go through this again.
And then his phone was ringing for real.
My heart was hammering even as I picked up the phone, because at that point I realized, unless this was the most poorly timed robocall in the history of mankind, that I had won the Nobel Prize.
His research dates back nearly three decades. His laboratory focusing on why mutations in genes known as tumor suppressor genes can lead to cancer. He and two other scientists share the Nobel Prize for deciphering the mechanism that enables cells to sense and adapt to changes in oxygen abundance. That discovery helped motivate the eventual successful clinical testing of anemia drugs, as well as VEGF and HIF2 inhibitors for the treatment of kidney cancer.
I can't think of a greater privilege than to do science that occasionally touches patients. And so that to me is the ultimate gratification, and that's the ultimate prize.
Dr. Kaelin's research also has implications in triple negative breast cancer. Research continues into developing therapeutic strategies related to these cancers. For Dana-Farber News, I'm Victoria Warren.